Dear students, so now I am going to discuss one of the important concept in coordination chemistry is oxidation number of central metal ion. Before going to that, one must know that we know that usually the transition metal ions form coordination complex. And meanwhile, they possess variable oxidation state. That means they do not have a single constant oxidation state like S and P block elements. In S and P block element, they possess definite oxidation state. But in case of D block elements, the oxidation state varies. One atom possesses more than 2 to 3 oxidation state. So this phenomenon is called as variable oxidation state. So that's why we have to know the oxidation state. And the oxidation state of a central metal ion in a coordination complex, it decides the properties like magnetic property, colored compound, catalytic nature. So these are all the properties which are depends on oxidation number of central metal ion. That's why we have to know how to calculate oxidation number of central metal ion. Dear students, you know how to calculate oxidation number of species, especially inorganic compound. You already studied some of the set of the rules in order to calculate oxidation number of various metals and non-metals in inorganic chemistry. Now when we come to coordination chemistry, the rules are same. Here also we are following the same rules. By keeping the rules, you have to know some of the extra things in order to calculate oxidation number of central metal atom. So the oxidation number of neutral ligand is 0. You know ligand. In the previous classes, we understood classification of ligand based on the charges. The charge oxidation number of the ligand is equal to its charge. If it is a neutral ligand, the charge is 0. If it is a negative ligand, so it is minus 1, minus 2, like that. And if you take the coordination sphere, you just observe the diagram. The species which is indicated within the square bracket, so these are called as this is a coordination sphere, and this is a the species which is present outside in order to neutralize this charge, it is called as counter ion. So now I'll take the coordination sphere. In the coordination sphere, so this is a positive coordination complexes. The total charge of the complexes coordinations sphere is equal to the sum of the charges of central metal ion, and so total charges of all the ligand must be equal to the charge of coordination complex, because it is very important. Based on this, we are going to calculate the oxidation state. So now let us go to calculation. So let us see this complex. In this complex, cobalt is a central metal ion, so it has 3 ligand: ammonia, water and chloride. Here ammonia is a neutral ligand, its charge is 0, and water is a neutral ligand, its charge is 0, and chloride is a negative ligand, its charge is -1. So now we are going to calculate the oxidation state or number of the central metal ion cobalt, CO. So now we do not know the oxidation state, that's why we have taken as X. X is unknown substance. And here there are 4 ligands, 4 amine ligands are there. So X plus 4 into 0, 0, this is the charge of. So we have to take the total charge of the ligand. So in the total charge of the ligand is equal to the number of ligand into its charge. So there are 4 ligands, its charge is 0 plus. So water, only one water ligand is present and its charge is 0 plus. So there is only one ligand, of charge minus 1, that's why we have taken as minus 1. It's equal to plus 2, because I told just before, the total charge of the complex is equal to the sum of the charges of central metal ion and ligands which is present in the coordination sphere. So the total charge of metal ion and ligand, it must be equal to plus 2. Then solve this. So x, so 4 into 0 0, 1 into 0 0. So finally we left with only minus 1. X minus 1 is equal to plus 2, x is equal to plus 3. So plus 3 is the oxidation number of cobalt. This is how we are going to calculate oxidation number. Once again, dear students, if you want to calculate oxidation number of central metal ion in any coordination complex, so take the oxidation number of central metal ion as x, and then so take the number of ligand, then plus, then take the number of ligands and multiply its charges, and so you sum and you solve, you simplify, finally you are going to get oxidation number of central metal ion. So now let us see the other examples. So let us see, take these complexes. So in these complexes, sodium is the counter ion, cobalt is the central metal ion, and S2O3 is the ligand. So now we are going to calculate so Na plus, this is a negative ligand. This is a negative ligand, its charge is minus 4, because there are 4 sodium, 4 plus, and this charge must be minus 4. Okay, now we are going to calculate the oxidation state of cobalt. Here oxidation state of cobalt is X, so we do not know X, and there are 3 ligands, and each ligand and its charge of this thiosulfate S2O3, this is the thiosulfate, the charge of this is S2O3 2 minus, so this is the charge of this ligand is minus 2. There are 3 ligand, each charge of each ligand is minus 2, is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 is the charge of this coordination sphere, and if you simplify this, X minus 6, 3 into minus 2, minus 6 is equal to minus 4, so X is equal to minus 4 plus 6, so plus 2 is the oxidation state of cobalt. And next example, so cobalt, so this is a complex, there are 8 carbonyl ligands are present. So let us take the oxidation state of cobalt is X. So X, actually there are, we have to take a positive sign here, X plus, there are 8 ligand, each charge is 0, 8 into 0, 0, if you simplify, so we are going to get 0. So this is a neutral complexes, this is a neutral complex. So now let us see another example of a complex, iron complex, which contain iron as a central metal ion, water as a ligand, and nitrosyl. This is a special case. Here nitrosyl, it's a positive ligand, and sulfate is a counter ion. So now take oxidation state of iron, we do not know, that's why it is X. There are 5 water molecule and its charge is 0, plus there is one nitrosyl of charge, that's why 1 into plus 1, so it becomes 1, plus of minus 2 is equal to 0. Here why they took minus 2, they include this one also. Here you just look at here, I told that the sum of the total charge of central metal ion and ligand which is present inside the bracket is equal to what? Is equal to its charge plus, okay, its charge plus 2. You can calculate in this way also. Or the total charge of a coordination complex including counter ion is equal to 0. The sum of the charges of central metal ion, ligand and counter ion is equal to 0. That's why here they are taken minus 2. You can calculate in another way also. X plus 5 into 0 plus 1 into 1 is equal to plus 2. What is where, here plus 2 is the charge of the complex. Okay, both the ways are is equal to plus 2 or minus 2. Minus 2 is the charge of sulfate ion. Either you can take the charge of the sulfate, include the charge of sulfate ion, you can take in the LHS, or you can take the charge of this positive ion on RHS. So if you, dear students, you while solving this problem, you solve in both the ways, you will get the same answer. So here X, it is 0, so plus 1, so the total charge is, charge of iron here is, so iron is in plus 1 oxidation state. So 5 into 0, 0, plus 1 and minus 2, so is equal to, the charge is plus 1. Now let us see another two examples of coordination complex. So NCS, isocyanate of amine and sulfur trioxide, this is a counter ion. So now let us calculate. So now sulfur trioxide of charge minus 2, that's, and the charge of coordinations, that's the sphere is plus 2. Now let us, the cobalt oxidation state of cobalt is X, and the charge, so there is only one ligand is present of charge minus 1, that's why 1 into minus 1 minus 1, and there are 5 ligands are present, so of charge 0, 5 into 0 0 is equal to plus 2. Plus 2 is the charge of the coordination sphere. If you simplify, you will get plus 3. Plus 3 is the oxidation state of cobalt ion. And similarly, take other example of cobalt complex containing cobalt central metal ion, ammonia as a ligand, and chloride. So chloro is a another ligand, and sulfate is a counter ion. You know, sulfate possesses SO42 minus, and charge is plus 2. You know, these charge of these simple radicals. Let us take the coordination number of X, cobalt is X, and there are 4 ammonia of charge 0, and there are 2 chloride of charge minus 1, is equal to plus 2 is the charge of the coordination sphere. And if you simplify, you will gain X minus 2 is equal to plus 2, X is equal to plus 4. Plus 4 is the oxidation state of central metal ion. So this is how you can calculate the oxidation state of central metal ion by very simple method. For this, in order to calculate, you must know charges of the ligand. You must know charge of the coordination sphere. It can be calculated easily by just looking the charge of counter ion which is present outside the complexes. So this is very simple. As I told in the beginning, the charge of the complex is very important. The charge of a coordination complex, it decides the many properties like magnetic, color, catalytic. That's why one has to know the oxidation number of central metal ion in a coordination complex.